May I invite the High Commissioner of New Zealand, David Pine, to present his credentials.
Namaste, Honourable President. Tēnā koutou katoa. I bring the warm greetings of Her Excellency, Governor General of Aotearoa New Zealand. I have the honour to present her letters, appointing me as High Commissioner to the Republic of India and recalling my predecessor.
Excellency, I warmly accept your credentials. My best wishes to you for a successful tenure in India. Thank you.
Honourable President, Namaste. I'm delighted to present to you today my letter of credentials as the incoming British High Commissioner and the letter of recall of my predecessor, signed by Her Majesty the Queen Elizabeth II.
Excellency, I warmly accept your credentials. My best wishes to you for a successful tenure in India. Thank you.
Honourable President, Namaste. I have the honour to present my credentials as Ambassador of Republic of Uzbekistan to the Republic of India and the letter of recall of my predecessor.
Excellency, I warmly accept your credentials. My best wishes to you for a successful tenure in India. Thank you. Excellencies, I am delighted to receive your credentials. My heartiest congratulations to you on your appointment. These are challenging times. The COVID-19 pandemic poses several limitations on us. We are fortunate, however, that digital technology provides us with options to innovate and function. We are optimistic that the global community will soon find a solution to the pandemic. India is contributing to the ongoing global efforts to produce a vaccine. India has also been at the forefront of providing medical support to fellow countries to fight the COVID-19 pandemic. The need for greater global cooperation to ensure our collective health and economic well-being has never been more pressing. Excellencies, India has warm and friendly relations with all the three countries represented here. Our ties are deeply rooted in history. We are also privileged to share a common outlook on defining issues that shape the 21st century narrative. Our multilateral engagement at the United Nations, the Commonwealth, and the Shanghai Cooperation Organization are yielding appreciable results. I would like to thank your governments for supporting India's candidature for the non-permanent seat of the UN Security Council for the term 2021-22. And we look forward to working closely with your delegations at the United Nations. We also look forward to working with the United Kingdom in the UN Security Council. Excellencies, India's relations with New Zealand are deepening. Our leaders have been meeting at regular intervals, and this has led to significant expansion of our cooperation both at the bilateral and multilateral level. We are much encouraged by the leadership shown by Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern to fight the pandemic. People-to-people links provide further richness to our relationship. I am happy to see that the Indian diaspora has become a living bridge between our two countries. India and the United Kingdom are natural partners, bound by historical ties and shared values of democracy. Our relationship spans across a range of sectors, from trade, investment, economic links, to education, science and technology, defense and culture. Strong people-to-people connections have been a pillar of our relationship. Indian diaspora in the UK is making significant contribution to enhancing our mutual understanding. Excellency, I was delighted to host the Prince of Wales in Rashtrapati Bhavan in November last. We look forward to the visit of Prime Minister Boris Johnson to India at an appropriate time. India and Uzbekistan have been civilizational friends. We are strategic partners today. I am pleased that regular bilateral exchanges between our two countries have achieved substantial progress. Investment, agriculture, education, defense, and cultural ties. Excellency, please convey my warm regards to President Shavkat Mirziyoyev. I have vivid memories of his successful state visit to India in October 2018. Excellencies, it has been a pleasure to meet you all. I wish you all success in your tenure in India and a safe and pleasant stay here. Thank you.